We will keep you posted on all the drama in the javelin. It is a fantastic competition. On the track, we turn our attention to the men's 5,000 metres. What a showdown this is going to be. The roll call of champions tells you how highly prized this title is. Paavo Nurmi in the 20s, Emil Zatopek in the 50s, Lassie Viren in the 70s, Saeed Awita in the 80s, El Garouge in the noughties, Kenenisa Bekele, Mo Farah across the late noughties and the teens. A new champion will come from this list of 16 men, three from the United States, three Ugandans. We do have representation from Ethiopia in the form of Milkesa Mengesha.
In lead after the first round.
Showtime in the 5,000 metres. Andy Butchart on the outside, sixth in Rio. Fisher ran so well in the 10,000 metres, he was fifth. Mengesha, Joshua Cheptegei, the world record holder, the world champion over 10,000 metres, silver here. Can he claim a gold where no Ugandan has trodden before? Paul Chelimo of America, he got the silver 5 years ago. And there's Jacob Kiplimo, he got the bronze behind his compatriot 5 years earlier in these games and made his debut in the Olympics as a teenager in Rio. Both with experience from two games and how much they'll need it. Watch for Mohammed Ahmed, fantastic Canadian in the mix. And is this guy going to shine for the Spaniards? Massive PBs at the 1500, 3000 and 5000. Katia is on fire this year. He could be the man to spring a surprise. Woody Kincaid. One Kenyan in the form of Nicholas Kimeli. Justin Knight. Ninth in the World Champs 4 years ago. Very fast this year, 12.51. None of these men have won Olympic gold before. A new champion is about to be crowned. Between them, they will have covered hundreds of thousands of kilometres in training. The next five will define one of their lives. This is distance running drama of the highest quality. It's the men's 5,000 metre Olympic final. They are away. 12.5, lung-bursting, intriguing, utterly unpredictable laps of the track. And I wonder whether we'll get some team tactics at play between the three Ugandans. And there is massive excitement in Kampala and in Jinja, all across the proud East African nation. They believe that we're Chemetai delivered gold for Ugandan women in the steeplechase, that their men can follow suit. Remember, Joshua Cheptegei was on fire last year with so many world record performances. He has found it difficult this year. On paper, he'd be the favourite for this, but it's going to be very, very hard to follow up silver in the 10 with gold in the 5.
He mentioned in his media availability after the 10 that he had been dealing with some heel soreness after the trials and in his training, and that's affected him some. Now, it only affected him into a silver medal position, but interesting to watch because he has admitted to some degree he is not physically exactly right.
We're mentioning about the Spaniard. He moved from Morocco to Spain when he was 5. Gave a hint of his form to come this year.
And 67.29 PB, and that's the season's best because she had 64.56 so far.
Jacob Kiplimo leading. That's Mohamed Katia just towards the halfway stage of this pack. Joshua Cheptegei is in fourth. The other Ugandan is just at the back at the moment, Oscar Chelimo, who, by the way, is the stepbrother of the man leading, Jacob Kiplimo. Only 20 years of age, already with an Olympic bronze medal. Behind that fella, Joshua Cheptegei in the 10,000 metres. Still no move from Katia. It's a good, honest pace, this, and I wonder if there are some team tactics at play here, because they've clearly decided they don't want this to turn into a last two-lap burn-up.
No pacer here, no pacing light, so it's a little different to see how it shakes out, because it can shake out any number of ways. If you just look at the last two that Mo Farah won, he won one in 13.03 and one in 13.41. So there's a lot of ways to play this out. I would think at some point somebody's going to have to put in a surge of 60-second laps for two, three, maybe even four laps to see what everybody else has.
And I wonder if the Ugandans are doing this deliberately because they know Katia has got great speed in his legs. Just to give you an indication as to his PBs, as Oscar Chelimo comes up wide on the outside. 3.28 this year, national record for the Spaniard just in the middle of the pack. 12.50 for the five, and a national record 7.27 when he out-sprinted an in-form Stewie McSwain over 3,000 metres before coming here. So the harder they can make this pace, the more tired they make Katia, and the less likely he is to be able to burn them all off over the last 400 metres.
And to touch a little more perspective on the numbers you gave, that's an 8-second PR in the 1500 that he put down, a 17-second PR, and a full minute PR over this distance.
The other main protagonists we haven't spoken about, I've met him actually, and he's such a lovely man. Paul Chelimo is running in second place. You just saw him glance up there, the American expatriated Kenyan, proudly serving the armed forces in the United States. He's made his home there for a long time. Absolutely no indication he's gone there for money. He's a proud American now. He's in second place, and he got the silver behind Mo Farah 5 years ago, and he looks very calm and very composed there in second place. He fancies he can upset everyone, and he's quite happy that Jacob Kiplimo is setting the pace because he's ticking off the early laps and tucking in second for the ride.
Got a brief shot there of Justin Knight. I think there's a guy who's an outside chance to get on the podium. You should watch him. He's run well, much like Atir. He's dropped some PRs down significantly this year, and a really well-regarded runner in Canada and in North America because he ran at Syracuse, helped lead them to their first national championship in cross-country. He's a former cross-country national champ, and I know how you like those guys to bring that kind of strength to your races.
I love the cross-country runners. It is not a coincidence that Joshua Cheptegei stormed to all those world records last year on the back of becoming world cross-country champion in 2019. I was there in Kampala when he blew up, relinquishing an enormous lead in the world cross. In the independence grounds, the Kololo independence grounds in the heart of the capital. And he learned a great lesson from six laps to go in the men's 5,000 metres. And I just noticed Joshua Cheptegei taking the lead once more. Not happy because the pace just began to drop a fraction. He clearly doesn't want this to turn into an all-out sprint. He feels his best chance of a medal, or perhaps his best chance of glory, comes by winding it up. And we've mentioned the two Canadians, Mohammed Ahmed, Commonwealth silver medalist, over the 5 and the 10 behind Cheptegei on the Gold Coast. I commentated on that, two cracking races between them. He's in the mix, along with Justin Knight, the fifth fastest in the world this year, the other Canadian there, just on the curb, running in around about fifth or sixth place. And there is Mohammed Katir, the director, doing a fantastic job to give us a glimpse of all the main protagonists here. And just a quick clarification as to which of the Ugandans has dropped off the back. That's Jacob Kiplimo. He's the reigning world half marathon champion. He's very much still in the shake-up. It's the third Ugandan, Kiplimo's stepbrother, Oscar Chelimo, who is drifting off the back of the pace. Everybody else is still just about in touch, including Nikesha Mengesha of Ethiopia. Another great cross-country runner, took the world junior title on that brutal course in Aarhus. So the Ethiopian can't be discounted at this stage. He's running in fourth, and they've slowed again. And maybe these conditions, John, are making it too hard to strike this early. There is incredible humidity in the air.
They went through 3K on a pace for about 13:20. Manesha, who's there, right, the Ethiopians, they've got a medal in five straight games, so a proud sporting tradition in this particular race. And it's the first time in three games that the winner of the 10 has not come back to run and win the five, and so his countryman, Salman Barega, who would figure in this, is not here.
Yes, Borrega focusing on the longer distance, a magnificent goal for him. Cheptegei and Kiplimo creating history for Uganda. I think it was the first time they'd had two on the podium. Katia is still very much in the mix. He's got no interest in the pace at the moment. He's quite happy to tag along for the ride in the pack. I am talking about the man in red for Spain, five from the back of that group, and they are still single file. Kimeli now leading, Mengesha still there, so too Cheptegei. And what about the two Canadians tucked on the inside in about fifth and sixth? Mohammed Ahmed and Justin Knight, and Bailiu coming out on the outside, the former Ethiopian who now represents Bahrain and won the Asian Games in very hot, sticky conditions in Jakarta 3 years ago. So he'll be comfortable in this humidity.
That's a sapper for sure, that humidity when he comes through. Paul Chelimo decides he wants to go back to the front. He won the American Trials this year. When he came through and medaled the last time around, he was third in the trial. So some of it has to do with how do you keep your form, how do you peak, how do you get yourself better again 6 weeks later to come to this. And the Americans, they ran in searing heat, and Eugene as well. And I think to some degree, to ask that of yourself again, you wonder if they're fully recovered from what happened in the trials just because of the heat.
Coming round now. Less than a kilometer to go, and there are two distinct groups. Andy Butchart of Great Britain has been dropped. So too the other Bahraini, Dawit Fikadu, and the Guatemalan in the race. This is going to be absolutely fascinating over the last 800 meters. A big group. Two laps to go in this 5,000 meter final, and it is still absolutely anyone's. The two Canadians running really well on the inside. The two Ugandans, their third teammate has been dropped, but Joshua Cheptegei is still in the mix, along with Jacob Kiplimo and that man there, Mohamed Katia, a proud Moroccan who now proudly flies the flag for Spain. He's been there since the age of five. He's in the best form of his life, and there's almost a little push and a shove and a fall there. But Paul Chelimo, the silver medalist representing the United States from 5 years ago, stays on his feet, and they are beginning to jostle for position. Prepare for takeoff. This is going to be an electric last 500 metres. Cheptegei is preparing to put himself in the right position, but there are an awful lot of quick men queuing up behind him.
Well, we said if we thought it was 13:30, you could have 10 guys. It's eight.
They take the bell in the final of the men's 5,000 metres. Joshua Cheptegei, a national hero, an icon in Uganda, striking out to try and secure their first gold. Six men in the mix, and Mohammed Katia is not with them. He's got five for company, and five into three does not go. Cheptegei leads. It's Kimeli in second for Kenya, and Paul Chelimo ready to pounce. Cheptegei has 110 metres to claim history for Uganda. He's pulling away. Can he do it? Can he keep it going? Watch for the Canadian. He's closing, but not quickly enough. The world record holder becomes the Olympic champion. At last, Joshua Cheptegei secures the gold he has craved for years. So many runs, so many thousands of kilometres. And after the near miss in the 10,000 metres, he's done it. He's climbed the mountain. Uganda's first champion over 5,000 metres. He's done it with his compatriot. He's done it with heart. He's done it with passion. And he's proven that as a world record holder, he can come and deliver under pressure when the times are irrelevant. What a night it's going to be in Uganda. Cheptegei has taken one of the ultimate crowns.
No one could catch him, but great close by both Mohammed of Canada. He comes rolling in, and Paul Chelimo, good to the very last drop as he just dives and falls across the line for yet another major medal for him. Here's Mohammed, Canadian, went to the University of Wisconsin, so there's pride in Madison down on State Street. Long as we're naming the places where you might go get a cold one, you can get that, or anywhere you would like across the provinces of Canada.
Great run from Ahmed for the silver. And what a brilliant bronze for Paul Chelimo on the podium for a second successive games. And I noticed out the corner of my eye as I was watching Cheptegei, it was the most dramatic lunge for the line. Chelimo was so low, he almost fell across the finish line. Well, if you are watching in Uganda, Oliochia, Katir was the man who came in with a great reputation, but on the last lap he faded. Ahmed closed the gap on Cheptegei, but the 10,000 metre silver medalist was not to be denied. At this point, you thought the upset and the lead could be curtailed. It was really brave to go with 500 to remaining. And as he pulled away here, he was looking in the big screen and he could see Ahmed was closing, but the Canadian had left himself too much to do over the last 50 metres. You cannot underestimate what a big achievement this is for the Ugandans. What a games they're having. They've already taken one gold, now a second, to go alongside the silver and bronze for Cheptegei and Kiplimo over the 10,000 metres. And that's taken real heart to do that, because he hasn't been as good this season as he was last year when he broke all the world records. That took real courage to come here and do that.
And there you see the full-on effort by Chelimo. I think he was safe, but he was going to make sure that he was in there and nabbed that last bronze, and Camelli just not quick enough. And it's funny, you watch with Cheptegei, because you have all the records, and you think, listen, his greatness is stamped. You know what he is. And yet now, to have that medal, how it fully flowers his career.
Yeah, huge. Him and his coach, Adi Ruta, have done such good work. Well, slowly and surely, we're edging towards the end of the athletics here at Tokyo 2020, so the medal ceremonies are coming quite quickly after the athletes have stepped off the track. No chance for a shower, but a quick change, a drink, maybe a few text messages home. I've just had a quick look on social media, and the reaction in Uganda is going absolutely berserk.
Really? Bonkers, huh?
William Frederick Glick, IOC member for Uganda. Without doubt, their finest games so far. Remember, silver and bronze in the men's 10, gold in the women's 3,000 steeplechase, and now gold in the men's 5,000 metres. And Beatrice Ayikoru confirms an all-Ugandan lineup for this medal presentation. World Athletics Council member. It really is such a special country. You cannot emphasise enough what this result will mean for them. Let's focus on the bronze medalist. Second successive Olympic podium finish for Paul Chelimo, a man who moved his life from Kenya to the United States. Very proud to do so. He did it for all the right reasons. And with one of the most dramatic dips for the line you'll ever see in a 5,000 metres, he confirmed bronze instead of fourth. It was a dip that the two-time world sprint hurdle champion Colin Jackson would be proud of. He famously used to dip so low he'd fall over. Chelimo did, but in so doing, he'd secured another podium. Great stuff from the American.
Canada. Silver medalist Canada. Gold medalist Canada.
Mohammed Ahmed should be so proud of his medal for a fantastic North American nation. What a games this is turning out to be for the Canadians. Incredible. Taking the men's two, the men's decathlon, and now a silver in one of the hardest distance races ever contested. 258 plus bits.
Look at him just examine that thing. He's just, it's real.
Oh, there's so much hard work that goes on with the Canadian distance running scene. Great races in Ottawa and Toronto, all across the country. I've had the privilege of going there, and they're so passionate about their distance running, and they'll be so pleased for Ahmed.
Gold medalist and Olympic champion Uganda.
The national icon can hardly believe what he's hearing, because the stadium announcer has just said, Joshua Cheptegei, you are the Olympic champion. World records are all well and good, and he has a whole list of those. But the one thing missing from his collection was an Olympic title. Ever so close in the 10, a great effort for silver, and I think it reignited his confidence, because it hasn't been the perfect season for Cheptegei, but I tell you what, it's the perfect finish. He'll go back home to Kampala, the toast of a nation. What a party awaits Joshua Cheptegei, and what a proud, proud moment for him and all his friends and family watching back home across a great nation. They turn to once again hear the Ugandan national anthem for the second time in this stadium. We're looking at a man who will never have to buy a bottle of Nile Special ever again, anywhere in his home country. Joshua Cheptegei is the Olympic champion.
I don't know that we've seen a happier threesome than that group. And maybe because it's still the euphoria of the moment, it was so close. But without a doubt, those three medalists right there have been the happiest, the most joyful. They are just exuding the joy that they have from those finishes.
He came here capable of the double, arriving here as the reigning world record holder over the 5 and 10.